We assume that we have a point cloud of scanned data. The point should belong to a line here in this area, but there is some noise. And also we have some outliner here and here, which are scanned, and we want to find the curve, which is the medium of this data set. So we can use a method which is called convolution. Convolution is described here in the Wikipedia, and convolution we can see here is a process where I have some data and I can modify them to get easier to use new data set. In this way, a frame is running over the data and transforms the data symbol set, and we do this here for our data set. So we have the approximation first step, and what we see here is we have here a medium line. In a certain sense, we have some approximation data. If I close this light, then I see here how the approximation works. And the problem what we have here is that we have some of these outliners and they have some influence on the curve. So it would be better to have, instead of this outliner, first a step where we can delete them. And this is the other algorithm. We do this again, yes, now with outliner detection. And in this case, we see we have here a better curve. This one. So I delete still all again and recalculate without outliners. So, and now we can look into detail. We have the curve here. We start the grid. And so we can go into detail. And in this case, we see here some details. We see the red points, the starting point set. We see the approximation steps. I hide them. And this is the last set. And now we can draw through this last iteration a D-wire polygon. And this D-wire polygon has about 100 points. And now to get a B-spline, we can use the approximation algorithm for the B-spline. And the B-spline is here. And it only has 10 to 12 points, poles. And it's nearly like the green line in this case. So the distance is only less than 1 millimeter. The approximation algorithm now runs with dots 3 millimeter. That is fine enough. Okay, the running time for this algorithm in one iteration step is less than 1 millisecond per point. So that means we also can compute larger data sets with hundreds or 1,000 points in an acceptable time.